Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, my name is Wendy. Welcome for the very first time. Please excuse this painting in the back. I need to find a place to hang it. But today's video is gonna be so exciting because I wanna share one of my favorite handbags with you guys. Are you guys ready? Ta-da! It is the Louis Vuitton Pochette Matisse. I'll run you guys through all the details about this bag, and because I've had it for a few years now, I want to run you guys through my thoughts on it. What are the pros? What are some of the cons? And then at the very end, I'll show you guys modeling shots in terms of what it looks like on me, on my height. So let's get started. Okay, so let me quickly run you guys through some of the basic details of this bag. So actually right off the bat, it looks pretty big on camera, but in person, it actually looks a lot smaller and a lot more dainty. If you guys see me looking down, it's because I have some numbers that I want to read off to you guys regarding details of this bag. But right now, the bag costs $1,980, which with tax, it's going to be a little bit over $2,000. As you guys can see, I got mine in just the classic monogram print, but they also have the reverse monogram, which is like the lighter monogram color up here matched with the darker one down here, and they also have it in the leather options, which is going to be slightly more expensive just because this is canvas, so the leather ones are going to be a little bit thicker and a little bit more expensive. Those, I believe, come in 5 different colors. And in terms of sizing of this bag, so the height of this bag is about 7.5 inches. The length is about 9.8 inches. And then the width of this bag with the 3 pockets right here is about 2.8 inches. And obviously the bag does come with a strap. So I have my strap right in here. When I store it, I typically like to put the strap on the inside. When you first buy it, it comes at about 19.9 inches. But because it is adjustable, the maximum drop length it can go to is 21.7 inches. There are 7 holes on the strap that you can adjust to based on your height. I have mine currently set at the 2nd to last one. And the straps on this bag come off so easily. That is something that I really love about it. You guys can see it's just very easily opens and closes, and all you have to do is kind of put it up against the hole and it just kind of clasps onto itself. Same thing for the other side. So in the front right here, it has what Louis Vuitton calls as an S-lock, and then it just says Louis Vuitton Paris. And how you open it is you just push one side and the lock will pop open. So let me show you guys. You just push this side right here and then it just pops open like that. And when I first got this bag, I thought that you were supposed to push both sides for the lock to pop open, but actually one side is stale and only one side moves. So when you get your bag, don't be afraid, because I thought mine was broken, but it's actually just designed like that. Only one side is supposed to move. So once it pops open, you can either open it like this or you can pull on kind of the leather part like this. When you open it up, you will see 3 compartments. There is a small compartment in the front, a medium compartment in the middle, and then a slit compartment in the back. And the entire inside is lined with Louis Vuitton's very typical kind of brown textile lining. Right here, it does also say Louis Vuitton Paris. So you guys can see sizing from the side profile. The one in the back is very thin. You can probably only fit some, you know, cards or papers. I put most of my stuff in the main compartment in the middle, and then in the front I typically will put my cell phone. So as you guys can see, this bag does fit quite a bit of stuff just because it has so many compartments. And in the back, you do also have a separate zipper compartment. Again, it is also lined in the same material. If you get a bag that has kind of a rougher zipper, you can go into Louis Vuitton and they can wax it for you. Then on the top right here, it does have a top handle. It is held in place by these 2 leather hoops, and it is in the Vaquetta leather, just like the part right here. The top just also says Louis Vuitton Paris. So now that we've gone through some of the details, let me start off by going over some of the pros of this bag and what I really, really do appreciate about it. So obviously the number one pro is just how beautiful this bag is. Ugh, I just, literally, it's just the piece that I just can't help staring at every time I use it. And even with like jeans and leggings, I can totally rock this bag. It's not something where I would have to always match with like more dressy outfits. It's definitely something you can match with more casual outfits as well, so I love that about this piece. One of the main pros is obviously the material. With the canvas material on like leather, it's, you know, so much more hassle-free. It's very, very durable, very, very prone to scratching, and very weatherproof. So if you get water or rain or whatever on it, it doesn't really show. So it holds up so well over time. And obviously another great thing about canvas material is that it's just so light. So because I always overstuff this bag, it really helps that the bag itself is very light. And I definitely do think this bag is a great investment, just because I don't think this bag is very picky and choosy in terms of the age of someone wearing it. So for example, for me, as someone in my 20s, I can definitely rock this bag. And my mom also loves borrowing this bag as well, so it looks so amazing on her. So I can definitely see myself using this bag for literally the rest of my life, because I can't think of an age where it wouldn't look, you know, appropriate on me. I got this bag a little over 2 years ago, and I think by the time I was getting it, they kind of already changed up the canvas, because previously I heard the canvas material was very, very hard and stiff. And then by the time that I was already getting it, I think they've changed it up quite a bit so that it's like a thinner canvas material, but because of that, it's so much softer, so much more squishy and pliable. So I definitely feel like this bag is very comfortable to wear. And even with the straps, I think the strap, when I first got it, it was a little bit stiff, but over time it definitely did soften up. So when I'm wearing this bag crossbody, I don't feel it digging into me at all. I don't feel like it's very burdensome on my body, which I love, especially for traveling. And another pro I want to mention about this bag is actually not about the bag itself, but it's a separate product that I use with this bag that's helped maintain it. So as you guys probably heard online, there is something called an Apple Guard spray, where if you spray it on Makita leather, number one, it makes it waterproof, so you won't get any water marks if you go into the rain. And number two, it kind of seals the Makita so that it becomes almost non-reactive to the environment or the oil on your hands. So therefore, it prevents it from changing into that golden brown color over time. I am actually so jealous of people who have Louis Vuitton items with Makita leather, that they're able to have the fit Makita turn into an even golden brown color. I think it's so beautiful. But I just, like, I don't know why, like, my Makita leather always turns out into like spotty brown, where it's like different shades of brown, and it just starts to look really bad. So now that we have talked through some of the pros of this bag, I do want to run you guys through some of the cons or potential cons of this bag. As you guys probably know, this bag is infamous for some of the potential mishaps that could happen. So I am someone that if I'm spending like more than $300, I will watch the heck out of reviews, meaning that I think I've watched every single YouTube review out there on this bag before I got it. So again, I was very cautious about this bag just because of the possible things that it could happen to it. But thank God to the purse gods out there, I have actually not experienced most of those potential problems. But I just want to make sure you guys are aware of what you could be running into. One problem a lot of people talk about is cracking. These areas on the bag, like right here, all the way around, is actually glazed. This happened a lot with the older version of the bag, so if you're buying the bag now, I wouldn't be as worried, just because, like I said, they changed up the canvas a little bit, so it's softer now. But in the past, because it's been like a harder and stiffer material, a lot of people started to see their glazing starting to crack. With that said, if you do take it back to Louis Vuitton because of cracking, they actually will send it back for free and have the entire bag reglazed for you. And I've heard that could take up to like 1 or 2 months, which is extremely inconvenient, especially if you are using this bag on a daily basis. To have it be away from you for like 1 to 2 months, that is a long time. If you're buying this bag pre-love, that's a couple years old, definitely have the seller take pictures of the surrounding glazed areas for you and make sure there's no cracks. Another problem that I have heard about this bag is something that could potentially happen if you're using this as solely a top handle bag. So meaning if you're not going to use the straps at all and you're planning to just hold the bag like this every single day, then this could be something that could happen to you. But I've heard people say online that this top handle part, the leather, like this part, can almost come through the loop right here. So this could almost fall out. So if you feel like on days where you have this really overstuffed and it's really heavy, I would highly recommend not using it as a top handle bag and just using the straps instead, because you really don't want to risk that happening with your bag. So Louis Vuitton, they can replace like these parts for you, but if you replace this, keep in mind you'll have to replace the hoops as well, or else it's going to be a different color. And a third con that I've heard that could happen is that I've heard they're actually not very consistent in terms of the canvas material that they use for the straps. I've seen some online reviews of people getting really, really stiff straps that actually don't soften up at all over time. Thank God my softened up, but some people's straps are so stiff that they don't even fall down. They just completely kind of look like that. And with those reviewers, I've heard that the strap is extremely uncomfortable. So they're almost not even able to use the bag unless if they swap out the strap for like a different Louis Vuitton strap, which is extremely unfortunate just because this bag is made to fit quite a bit of stuff. To have a strap that feels uncomfortable and is digging into your shoulders, I can't imagine that would be a bag that people would want to keep. So because of that, I would highly advise, if you guys were to get this bag brand new, I would recommend going into stores to get the bag so you can try on the strap for yourself and find one with a comfortable strap. Because the price you're paying, you guys want to make sure that you're buying one where you don't feel like the strap is a hassle to wear, if you know what I mean. And last but not least, the last con that I do want to talk about is that the gold hardware on this bag is for some reason extremely prone to scratching. I feel like it's more prone to scratching than some of the other Louis Vuitton bags that I have, especially this part right here, just because of this buckle part, how you see how it like protrudes out, and for it to clip into place, you have to clip it into the hole right here. So it's very easy to miss, obviously, because the hole is so small. So if you are in a rush and you're trying to close it, there will be opportunities for you to scratch this area quite a bit. So for a lot of people who do have this bag, there will be a lot of scratching right here. Now for me, I am very OCD. So when I use this bag, I literally, when I close it, I will take it off. This is crazy. I will take it off pretty much every single time, and I will align it exactly in place before I go ahead and give it a push. One day, if I got, you know, a lot of scratches on this, I don't see myself being bothered too much by it, just because it's very typical wear and tear of purses with hardware on it. So unless if someone is like super up close looking at my bag, I don't think they would notice at all. And I'm also not someone to take off the straps very often. So because of that, I don't see too much wear and tear on these gold hardware pieces. But if you do remove these quite a bit, you will start to see some of the gold hardware kind of wearing off a little bit. And again, for a price, you could go back to Louis Vuitton and have them, you know, fix these areas for you. But I would just recommend trying not to fuss too much with the straps. Okay, so now that we got some of the pros and cons out of the place, I do want to show you guys some modeling shots in terms of what this bag looks like on me. Why don't we say that it's too late for us now? Why do we stay when I blame you for the things that weigh me down? Cause in the echo of your sound, thank you guys so much for watching and liking today's video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye guys!